Thank you. po, magandang gabi po sa ating lahat. Tara at samahan niyo po kaming magpuri at magsamba sa Panginoon. Let's praise the Lord.
And
led me through the fire. In the darkest night, you are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. And all my life you have been faithful. Goodness of God. Let's sing again. All my life, and all my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I can make, oh, I will sing in the goodness. Goodness of God, oh, I will sing in the goodness of God, oh, I will sing in the goodness.
Good evening to everyone. Welcome in this edition of our online spiritual mentoring. At ito po ay nakita ko po na kailangan ng bawat isa sa atin to strengthen, to build up our faith na kahit anong mangyari sa anong mga nararanasan natin na hindi maganda, still, we can hope for the best, and our hope will be in full. Kaya napakaganda na maintindihan natin ang mga salita ng Diyos, kasi yung talaga ang pinanghugutan natin ng lakas. So I would like to welcome each and every one of you. Ma'am Mini Andaya, welcome, good evening. Ma'am Mini, Shinmei, Jessica D, Grace Joy Pecadiso, Shinmei Ramirez, Maxim Balderas, Yen Calianta, good evening ma'am, from Bukidnon, and Lobby Beauly Dilamar, good evening po. Brother Marshall, Jetlyn Keha Morilla, Ma'am Jetlyn, ito po ay teacher. Good evening to everyone. Kimberly May, also in Bukidnon. Good evening, ma'am. Evan Dumulon. Then Roslyn Moreto, also Ma'am Iya Binaraw, good evening. Grace Dayan, glory to God. At ito po ay ginagawa natin bago po ang ating mga trainings kasi para tayo ay ma-bless spiritually the same way sa ating mga ginagawa sa business, lalo tayong gaganahan. Kaya good evening po sa bawat isa. Mary Joy Calma, Ma'am Pastora Lita Lopez. Good evening, Pastora. Welcome po. Shannon Akein Halagat, also in Bukidnon. Bukidnon, this is Bukidnon also. Mariela Eloisa Dob. Good evening, Wesley. John Kevin Rico Puerto. Good evening, sir. Ezra Nehemiah Laika Dado in Dagupan. Silverster Kasuyon. Sir, good evening po. I miss you. Kaya, thank you for viewing with us tonight. Then, Mary Grace Garcia. Good evening, ma'am. Sian Orbiso in Cebu. Good evening, sir. Angeline Sanchez Mendoza. Welcome. And also, Judah Cepas Dug. Good evening, ma'am. Welcome ang bawat isa sa gabing ito. At napakaganda na makita natin ang mensahe, ang turo natin sa gabing ito. Napakahalaga po. Also, Michael Asistio Loyola. Good evening, sir. Good evening. God bless you sa pagro-royal. Good evening sa kay Eloy Alminiana, Honey Perolino, and also Warren Subiaga. Sir Warren, good evening, sir. Ito po ang ating mga kapulisan sa nagro-royal. Good evening to everyone. Sino pa dito yung mga United Phoenix? Si Raul Madola. Sir, ito po ang counselor natin sa Pasay. Good evening, sir. Raul. And also Katrina Kaigoy, Marie Ramirez, Ken Dispabiladeras. Sir Ken, ito po ay classmate ko nung high school. Good evening, sir. Ma'am Wilma, of course, Wilma Di Chavez, my loving wife, very supportive wife. Kaya glory to God for your life. Salamat. And the rest, hindi ko naman ano, Mariel. Sir Mariel, salute to you. Tarukin, good evening. Thank you for viewing with us. Also, Sharine Marteja. Pumanis, Sharin. Good evening, ma'am. You are welcome. Merlin Horboda and Laarni. Ito po ay, glory to God, realista now. Nagtuturo po ito sa school ng AIM. Kaya good evening, ma'am. Napoleon Carag. Good evening. Ma'am Mariel. Jeva Yap. Viodor. Ma'am, good evening. Welcome po sa gabing ito sa ating live. At maganda po na bago po tayo mag-training, I believe na matatapos natin ito bago ang training. Kaya good evening to everyone. And this evening ay napakahalaga na ng tinuro sa akin ng Panginoon kasi last night I was praying and meditating the Word of God, medyo hindi ko po maintindihan ng lubusan. Ang sabi nga doon, cursed is the man who trusts in man. Cursed is the man who trusts in man. May sumpa po ang nagtitiwala sa tao. And make his place is his strength. Medyo pinag-isipan ko po ito, what God wants to bring about in this verse. Kaya the Lord spoke in my heart this afternoon na nakita ko po ito na kailangan talaga, we need God's power. Kaya ang tingin kasi natin when we trust in man, makikita natin, and even in our own strength, makikita natin ang kahinaan talaga ng tao. Kaya ang tao nagkakasala, ang tao ay napapahamak kasi without God's power, we need God's strength. Ito po ang pinakita sa akin ni Lord. Ang topic po natin tonight is relying on God's power. Alam niyo po, ang Holy Spirit, God's power is given to us by God. Bakit po nais ng Diyos bigyan tayo ng kapangyarihan? Ito po ang sinabi niya sa 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. Sabi dito, "For God did not give us the spirit of fear." So, if you don't rely on God's power, whatever circumstance in your life, pwede kang mag-quit, pwede kang panghinaan, pwede kang matakot. Kaya nga sabi dito, "For God did not give us the spirit of fear, but of power." Kaya nga, ang gusto ni Lord, God will give you power. We rely on God's power. Sabi dito, tatlo po itong sinabi dito, "But of power, of love, and of sound mind." Kaya napakaganda na ang gusto ng Lord na magtiwala tayo sa Kanya and to rely on His strength for our whatever we want to do for His glory. Kaya dito po, nakita ko po dito, napakahalaga ng power, God's power. Bakit gusto ni Lord ibigay sa atin ang power po niya? At dito po nakita ko po dito ang problema kasi ng tao, the acts of the sinful nature. Kaya po pala ang tao na nagkakasala kasi ito po ang sinful nature ng tao. Kaya ang tao nagkakasala because we are all sinners, kahit sino po sa atin. Kaya there are many chaos or lawlessness in this world because we rely on our strength. We rely on man. We trust on man. Kaya pala, cursed is anyone who trusts in man. Kung sa tao tayo nakatingin, nagkadepende, hindi sa Diyos, kaya ang tao napapahama. Sabi nga dito, "And makes his flesh his strength." Ang gusto talaga ni Lord, we will rely on God's power. Kasi the acts of the flesh is obvious. Sabi dito, sexual immorality. I will enumerate the acts of the flesh, the sinful nature. The works of the flesh are evident. Sabi po dito, obvious. This is very obvious. Kaya nga ang daming problema sa mundo. Broken homes, broken families, because we rely on our flesh, ang sarili ang nasusunod, not God's power. We cannot resist temptation. We cannot overcome, lalo na yung mga negative things in our lives. We need God's power. Kasi ang strength ni Lord is available for those who believe, who trust in Him, who give His life to Him. Sabi niya dito, adultery. Nakikita natin yan, ang mga problema sa paligid. Fornication. Nagsasama ng hindi kasal. Sabi po dito, uncleanness, lewdness, idolatry. Ito, very obvious po ito. We put anything in the place of God. That is idolatry. Kaya nga ang tao nagkakasala sa Diyos. And sorcery. Sorcery, ito yung witchcraft. And hatred. Kaya po, nangyari po sa US ngayon, galit. At nangyari, lawlessness. Kaya po, ang flesh po, that is the work of the flesh. Jealousies, outbursts of wrath. And then, next, selfish ambition, dissension. Kaya po ang mga selfish ambition pala, hindi nalulugod si Lord. Kaya ang ginagawa natin talaga, when we help a lot of people, we also, tayo rin po ay nagbe-benefit. Kaya ang talagang focus natin is helping people. Sabi nga po dito, next is dissensions, yung pagkakanya-kanya. Heresies, yung mga pagchichismis ng ibang tao. Envy, murders, pagpapatay, drunkenness, revelries and the like, of which I tell you beforehand, just as I also told you in time past. Si Paul po ang nagsasalita dito, that those who practice such things will not inherit the kingdom of God. Kaya po pala may curse, those who trust in man, those who rely on his flesh for his strength. Kaya po ang ginagawa talaga natin, we seek God. We pray every day. We come to God in humility. And we ask God for His strength to empower us. Ito po ay kailangan natin. Kaya nga, yun po ang sabi ng Panginoon sa mga disciples. Wait in Jerusalem until you are endowed with power from on high. Because when the Holy Spirit comes on you, sabi po ng Book of Acts, you will receive power. When we receive the Holy Spirit as we believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, we receive the power of God. God wants to strengthen us. Kaya nga, if you want to be unshakable, you need God's power. Yan, yun po ang fruit ng Holy Spirit eh. Love, peace, joy, long-suffering or patience, gentleness, kindness, self-control. Kaya the fruit of the Holy Spirit, ito po ang kailangan natin. Kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control, and against such things, there is no law. Kaya nga, if we are living in the power of the Holy Spirit, makikita natin, magpo-flow, magmamanifest ang fruit ng Holy Spirit. Kaya po, ang pakikipagkapwa natin, it will create, kaya nga sa mundong ito, talagang mababawasan ang kasalanan. Mawawala yung mga galit, mawawala yung mga pag-aaway, pagkakanya-kanya. Kasi we are walking in the power of God's Spirit. We want to live in the power of God's Holy Spirit. Kaya ganun na lang, kailangan. Kaya pala, kailangan tayo ma-filled ng Holy Spirit every day. Ang ibig sabihin ng filled, to be controlled by the Holy Spirit. We need God's power in our lives. Kaya nga, binibigay ni Lord yun eh. To those who believe, kailangan natin ito. Kaya, alam niyo po, if you want to become, not only to become unshakable, alam niyo po, ang blessings ni Lord, we cannot measure. Napakalaki ng pwedeng mangyari sa atin. Secondly, napakahalaga po nito. Kasi God is able, sabi po ng Ephesians 3:20, God is able to do exceedingly abundantly more than we ask or imagine according to His power. Alam niyo yung mga blessings natin, minsan, hindi natin ano, it's the workings of God's power. It's the working of God in our lives. Minsan akala natin because of our sipag lang. No. It's because of God's power. Because God's favor is upon us. Binigyan tayo ni Lord yung mga answered prayers natin. Kaya nga sabi dito, God is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, more than we ask or imagine, according to His power, hindi po according to our own strength. We don't rely on God's, on our strength. We need to, God wants us to rely on His power. Kaya yung 10 bundles,
every day, it can happen. At nangyari nga po yun eh. Because of God's power, of God's strength na binigay niya sa atin, God's favor. Kaya po, if we want God to work in us, katulad ng sinabi ni St. Paul, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Actually, through Christ who gives us power. Yun po ang nais ng Diyos when we connect ourselves to God through Jesus Christ. Ang kailangan lang natin to have partnership with God, to let God reigns in our lives. From time to time, sinasabi ko sa Holy Spirit, reign on me. Strengthen me, O God, by your power. Kasi hindi ko kaya kung sa sarili ko. I am believing that God is working through me. Kaya nga, God is working by His mighty power. Alam niyo po, ang power ni God, unlimited. When we rely on God, when we trust in the Lord, and rely on God's power, makikita natin ang power pala ni God, exceedingly great, incredible, grabe, na minsan beyond our understanding. Kaya sabi nga dito sa Ephesians 1:19, and what is the exceeding greatness of His power? Exceeding greatness. Grabe. Of His power toward us who believe. That's why if you believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, you will receive the Holy Spirit. And we need to be empowered. Kaya ang tanong ko nga kay God eh, why we need to be empowered by your Holy Spirit? Kasi God is unlimited God. We can be victorious because of His power that is at work within us. Kaya sabi nga dito po, exceedingly greatness of His power toward us who believe. According to the working of His mighty power. Sabi natin, mighty power. God is Spirit. And He is working within us, in us, and through us. God wants to work through us. Because alam ng Diyos eh, God, alam ng Diyos ang ating mga weaknesses. Kaya in our weakness, God is strong. We rely on God's power when we see ourselves na hindi natin kaya, apart from you, Lord, I can do nothing. Yun ang nasabi ni David. Lord, you are my Lord. Apart from you, there is no good thing. Kasi alam niya eh. Alam niya yung sino siya. Kaya nga ang tao talaga ay may mga pagkukahinaan. Because we are sinners. Kaya tayo nagkakasala. But with God's power, we can be an overcomer. Kaya po, this incredible greatness of God's power, kailangan natin. It's beyond measure. God is giving the Holy Spirit to those who believe in Him. To those who rest in Him. Kaya po, ang kailangan lang natin trust in the Lord with all your heart. Give your heart to Jesus Christ. Alam niyo po, we only believe you will receive the Holy Spirit if you believe what Christ has done for us on the cross. You will be empowered by the Holy Spirit. You will receive the Holy Spirit who is your comforter, who is your advocate, who is your intercessor. Kaya nga, He intercede through us. And He is your strengthener. Kaya po, nasabi ni St. Paul, I can do all things through Christ who gives me strength. Do not rely on your own. Kaya sabi ng Bible, lean not on your own understanding. What God can do through you is more than you think or imagine. Exceedingly great. Kaya po, we need to have partnership with God. Ang kailangan natin talaga, ibigay kay Lord ang pag-devotion, ang pagsisik sa Kanya, pagpipray. Alam nyo, a prayerful person is a powerful person because we are connecting to God. When we pray, we are come near to Him in prayer and submitting our plans, our hearts to God. Makikita nyo po, He will empower you. He will empower us with His mighty power. Alam niyo po, His divine power. Ito po ang kailangan natin sa mundong ito. For godliness, para magawa natin ang tama. Para masunod natin ang kalooban ng Diyos. Actually, the Holy Spirit will reveal Himself to us. Yung mga purposes ni God sa buhay natin. Kaya kanina, I was thinking yung sinabi ni Lord, o sinabi ni Saint Paul sa 1 Corinthians 2:9. No eye have seen, no ear has heard, no mind has conceived what God has prepared for those who love Him. If you love God with all your heart, God's power will infuse in your life. God's strength will be upon you. If you give your heart to Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, because He died for us on the cross, to forgive us from all our sins, to cleanse us, to wash our sins away, so that the Holy Spirit, because His power actually is a person, the manifestation only of God's, but He is a person, the Holy Spirit, and the manifestation is the power of God. We need to be close to God. Kaya we will pray to Him. Let us come to God and make Him as the Lord of our lives. Believe in Him. Trust Him. Ang magagawa ng Diyos ay higit sa ating mga plano, sa ating mga iniisip. Kaya nga, put your faith in Him. Put your trust in Him. Let Him be the Lord and Savior of your life. He loves you more than you know. He loves you very much. You know, when He suffered on the cross, just to forgive us and to give us the Holy Spirit, His power to work within us. God wants to work within us by His power. God wants to have partnership with you, to be with you. Sabi ng Bible, I will ask the Father so that He will give you another comforter to be with you forever. God wants to be in your heart, the nearest to you, God. If you want God through Jesus Christ, if you want Jesus Christ to reign in your heart, just pray this prayer after me. I don't know you. Wherever you are, saan ka man nandoroon, just believe God is there. God is a spirit. He knows everything about you. He knows your need. Sometimes we fail. Alam niyo po, you need not to give up. Rise up in God's power. God will strengthen you every day. Kaya nga, give yourself to the Lord. Holy, let us pray. Father, thank you for sending your Son, Jesus Christ, to die, to take our place, to be punished, to sacrifice Himself, to pay the penalty of our sins. Lord Jesus, we believe that you died for me. And you rose again from the grave to give me eternal life. And even right now, I believe that you are my Savior and you are my Lord. Cleanse me now. Forgive me from all my sins and fill me with your power. Come, Holy Spirit, reside in me, live in me. Empower me, O God. Give me peace and joy in my heart. And I am believing that you are within me, that I can be an overcomer. I am victorious because of your power that is within me. I thank you, Lord, for your forgiveness. Thank you, Lord, for making me as a child of God. And thank you for your power. I receive now the empowerment of your Holy Spirit inside of me. Lord, every day, fill me with your Holy Spirit. Receive it now. Let the fire of God, the holy fire, come down to you, and the Holy Spirit to empower you by His power in the name of Jesus. Whatever we do, we need to rely on God's power to help us. He is our helper. The Holy Spirit is our comforter, our strengthener, our intercessor. I give you praise and I give you glory in Jesus' name, and say, thank you, Lord. I love you, Lord. I love you, Jesus. Amen and amen. Thank you, Lord. Thank you. Thank you for viewing with us this evening. Nice kung imbitahan kayo this Sunday, 9:30 in the morning. At expect great things from God. Meron pong magandang, napakagandang mensahe ang Panginoon. Come worship with us. Kasi ang heart natin, enthrone natin si Christ sa heart natin. We worship God even in through this platform. Hindi po ang church nagko-close. Ang church po ay hindi po kailanman nag-close. Kaya nga, we worship God in spirit and in truth. Kahit nasa platform na ito, God is there, God is here, God is everywhere. Kaya God bless you. Whatever your needs, whatever your prayers, may God meet all your needs, and God protects you. And God bless your teams, your businesses. Bless tayo ni Lord abundantly. May the Lord, His power, guide us every day and always. So, good evening, and God bless you all. God bless you all. Good evening. Thank you.